In the shadowy capital, Margaret and Thomas face an eerie force. Can they honor an ancient promise? Their journey unravels secrets heavier than stone. Prepare for Oath Keepers, the Dark Sedition, a capital nightmare. Now, as we prepare to dive into our story, make sure you're comfortable. Are you ready? It's story time. Capitol Hill, an imposing monument of power, draped in the enchanting hues of twilight, stood silent and mysterious against the sprawling canvas of the Washington sky. Its mighty dome, shimmering in the dying embers of daylight, reflected an eerie tranquility that belied the disquiet veiling its sacred corridors. Margaret Sullivan, seated at her desk in a corner office, marinated in the warm glow of a desk lamp, surveyed the legislative theater unfurling before her. Her gray eyes, hard as granite and sharp as a scalpel, darted from one congressman to the next, dissecting personalities and intentions with clinical precision. An unexplainable shiver ran down her spine, causing her to pause, her gaze drifting towards the window and the monolith outside. Something was awry, a specter of unease, the unseen tune of a discordant note in the symphony of bureaucracy. It clung to the recesses of her mind, an echo from a nightmare she couldn't remember. Elsewhere, the metallic echo of a broom against the Capitol's stone floors accompanied Tomas Ruiz on his nocturnal symphony of solitude. A young man of few words, he navigated the labyrinthine edifice with an ease born of familiarity, the custodian of the Capitol's unspoken stories. The shadows that evening seemed more pronounced, the silence deafening in its insistence. He sensed an otherness in the rooms he knew like the back of his hand, a chill creeping up his spine, goosebumps adorning his skin as if his body were privy to a secret his mind couldn't yet grasp. Late that night, Margaret, ensconced in the comfort of her home, received a call. Her mother's frail voice crackled over the phone, words tumbling out in feverish urgency. Amidst the incoherence, a thread emerged, a tale of an oath woven into the founding stones of the Capitol, a pact that echoed with ancient power. Margaret listened, her heart pounding against her ribs, the rational part of her brain attributing the cryptic words to her mother's sickness, yet another part, the primal, instinctual part, stirred with foreboding. Thomas, his duties at the Capitol completed, returned home to the small two-room apartment he called home. His dreams that night were a tempest of shadow and sound. Dark figures traced cryptic patterns around the Capitol dome, their faces shrouded, their voices a susurrus of whispers weaving an oath that echoed through the catacombs of his mind. The woman's voice, ethereal and commanding, infiltrated his dreamscape, and he woke with a start, drenched in cold sweat, her last words echoing ominously in his mind, "When the keepers fail, the dark sedition rises." As dawn splashed its first colors across the horizon, Margaret and Tomas, each isolated in their private struggles, began their days, unaware of the shared darkness gnawing at their peace. Their paths, unbeknownst to them, had begun to align, pulled by the invisible thread of an ancient oath that had begun its spectral sedition. Their ordinary lives, under the shadow of the Capitol, were poised on the brink of an extraordinary confluence. The city, in its morning bustle, shrugged off the eerie remnants of the night. The Capitol, bathed in the new day's light, stood stoic and impenetrable, its secrets buried deep within its hallowed halls, its spectral whispers silenced. Yet, as Margaret walked into her office and Tomas picked up his broom, a shared shiver of apprehension trembled in the air, the first haunting note of a nocturne yet to be composed. The morning sun slipped through the cracks in the curtains, casting a hesitant light on the room. Margaret sat at her mahogany desk, her fingers tracing the edges of an ancient leather-bound journal, a remnant of her family's past. Her mother's words echoed in her mind, the oath, the whispers of a pact she couldn't ignore. Across town, Tomas woke, his mind still echoing with the haunting whispers from his dreams, the woman's voice intertwining with the reality of dawn. His brows furrowed, recalling the dark figures dancing around the Capitol dome, a strange familiarity etched in the dream woman's features. With a sense of reluctant curiosity, Margaret turned the brittle pages of the journal, the musings of an ancestor, one of the original architects of the Capitol. Sketches of the building, the dome, the grand rotunda filled the pages, each accompanied by notes in an elegant script. As her eyes scanned the pages, a phrase caught her attention. "As we lay the foundation, we make our pact." The similarity to her mother's ramblings struck a cold, uncomfortable chord within her. In the labyrinthine halls of the Capitol, Tomas bumped into a figure in a hurry. Apologizing, he looked up to meet the gaze of Margaret. Recognition flashed through him. The woman from his dreams, standing before him, her gray eyes wide with surprise. A silent moment passed between them, a moment that felt timeless and strange, leaving an indelible imprint on their minds. Later that night, a power outage enveloped the Capitol in darkness. Margaret, who had been poring over her ancestor's journal, found herself alone, the only light coming from the moon, casting elongated shadows and breathing an eerie life into the ancient edifice. A cold gust blew through the hallway, carrying with it a spectral whisper, an echo of her mother's words, her ancestor's writings, and a chill that made her heart pound with an ancient fear. Tomas, working late due to the power outage, moved through the unlit corridors, his flashlight casting unstable shadows around him. The air was charged with an unusual energy, his skin tingling with anticipation, apprehension. His flashlight flickered over a mural he'd never seen before, figures that seemed familiar, dark figures dancing around the Capitol dome, the scene straight out of his recurring nightmares. A chill crept up his spine, a sense of dread settling in his heart. As dawn approached, Margaret and Tomas, each lost in their world of unsettling discoveries and shared apparitions, found themselves standing at the precipice of the unknown. The silent echoes of the spectral whispers grew louder, and the Capitol, the monumental bystander, stood as a testament to their shared experience, concealing within its grand architecture a story that was yet to fully unfold. Unseen to the eye, the threads of their fate had begun to intertwine, an ominous dance in the spectral waltz of power and horror. And so, as the night gave way to day, Margaret and Tomas found themselves standing on the brink of a journey that was far from ordinary. The whispers of an ancient oath, the chilling touch of unseen forces, and the intertwining paths of their lives had set the stage for an eerie narrative that was yet to unfold in the imposing shadow of the Capitol. In the soft glow of an antique lamp, Margaret's fingers traced the fading script of an old letter, a relic from her ancestors' time. The more she read, the deeper she plunged into the labyrinthine history of her lineage and the Capitol. Correspondences between the original architects, cryptic musings on responsibility, and a binding oath, all intertwined to form a story that seemed too fantastical to be true. On the other side of town, Tomas was in the Capitol's archival room, bathed in the sterile light of fluorescent bulbs. His gaze remained fixated on an enlarged photograph of the mural he'd seen during the power outage. The figures dancing around the dome, the woman with the striking gray eyes. It was a mirror to his dreams, a chilling reflection that convinced him of the supernatural. In her exploration of the past, Margaret found recurring mentions of an oath, a pact made to protect the Capitol against a dark sedition. The words echoed the whispers of her mother, the fragments of her dreams. Yet the deeper meaning of the oath, its true significance, remained shrouded in a mist of metaphors and allegory. Tomas, delving into the Capitol's history, stumbled upon references to a similar pact. His dreams, the mural, and now the archived documents all seemed to reverberate with the specter of the oath, a pact that appeared to be fracturing, with the resulting fissures giving way to a rising spectral force. Margaret and Tomas found themselves in the grip of the same nightmare. The oath shattering, the Capitol consumed by darkness, and the spectral force rising in power. Their dreams echoed with the same dire warning. The breaking of the oath heralded disaster. Their waking hours were filled with an unease that refused to abate, their nights haunted by visions of a darkened capital. Their paths crossed once more in the marble-clad corridors of the capital. There was a shared understanding, a silent recognition in their eyes. Driven by curiosity and a lingering dread, they found themselves engaged in an unexpected conversation. A shared secret, a mutual fear, and the quest for answers. Their narratives intersected within the grandeur of the capital's echoing halls. The dread of their shared nightmares, the spectral whispers growing louder, the cryptic warnings in the documents and murals, all seemed to point towards an ominous future. Their investigations into the past had unveiled a narrative that now seemed to be playing out in the present, a narrative teetering on the brink of a dark chapter. The massive clock in the Capitol Tower struck midnight. Its resounding gong echoed through the grand rotunda. The echoes, however, did not fade into silence. Instead, they morphed into whispers, a spectral chant that reverberated through the hallowed halls. The whispering oath, the ancient pact, seemed to be materializing into a terrifying reality. In the subtle tranquility of the Capitol's library, Margaret and Tomas found themselves engrossed in historical records, hunting for symbolic clues within the cryptic language of the ancient oath. The smell of old paper and the hushed rustling of turning pages filled the air, creating a cocoon around them that was isolated from the rest of the world. The spectral echoes of their dreams grew stronger with each passing night, invading their subconscious with images of darkened hallways and towering shadows. The spectral force seemed to reach out to them from the veiled recesses of their dreams, providing fragmented clues that they tried to piece together in their waking hours. It was within the Capitol's labyrinthine network of chambers and halls that they made their next discovery. Behind a forgotten door, dust-ridden and cobweb-encrusted, lay a room untouched by time. Its contents, a treasure trove of records and artifacts, held the collective breath of the architects who had breathed life into the Capitol. They uncovered hidden sketches of the mural, notes hinting at the true meaning of the oath, and a troubling depiction of a looming spectral force. The enigma of the oath began to unravel, and they found themselves on the precipice of a chilling revelation. The Dark Sedition was not just a metaphor for political upheaval, but referred to a malevolent spectral force. This entity was kept at bay by the oath. The sacred words acted as a mystical barrier that was anchored by the lineage of the architects, Margaret's ancestors. The weakening of the oath was a signal of the growing power of this spectral force, a dire warning of the disaster that could engulf the capital. Navigating the murky waters of ancient pacts and spectral threats, Margaret and Tomas found solace in their growing camaraderie. Their shared dread and intrigue transformed into a bond of mutual support, providing them with the strength to face the unknown. Fear was replaced by a sense of purpose, the necessity to decode the oath and stave off the impending crisis binding them together. It was past midnight when they heard it, a hollow groan reverberating through the marble halls of the Capitol, echoing the whispers of their dreams. The lights flickered, casting elongated, wavering shadows that danced to a rhythm only they could understand. It was a sign, a spectral cry that resonated with the whispers of the oath. The spectral sedition was nearing its rise. The labyrinth of historical records and hidden truths began to reveal their secrets to Margaret and Tomas. The old words took on a new meaning. Not only were they symbols on paper, but also carriers of an ancient responsibility. This oath was more than an artifact from a bygone era. It was a binding promise, a spectral chain anchored by the architect's lineage and solidified by a willing and understanding vessel. This spectral force was no longer confined to their dreams, but bled into their waking hours. Shadows flitted across their vision, always just out of focus, an ethereal dance that was always peripheral, but never unseen. The spectral whispers grew more tangible, a chilling symphony that wove around them, pulling them deeper into the oath's mystery. The spectral force was a demanding entity, and the pact was its chain. However, every chain needed an anchor, and that anchor was the architect's bloodline, Margaret. As the words of the pact began to make sense, the truth hit Margaret with a force akin to a physical blow. The oath required a sacrifice, a willing vessel who risked losing themselves to the spectral force to contain it. Faced with the grim revelation, Tomas found himself teetering on the precipice of an abyss. The implications of Margaret's potential sacrifice washed over him like a freezing tide. They had a choice to make, a decision that threatened to tip the balance of their world. Margaret, rooted in her lineage, found a reservoir of strength within herself. There was fear, yes, but there was also determination. She chose to embrace her fate. Together, they began preparations to reinforce the oath. The rituals were as old as the capital itself, and the chants were echoes of the past that carried the weight of their impending task. Their lonely journey took a surprising turn with the discovery of an unexpected ally. An old librarian, who had quietly observed their pursuit from the sidelines, emerged from the shadows of the capital's library. His knowledge of the oath's history and rituals was an invaluable asset. The spectral activity reached a fever pitch as they delved deeper into their preparations. Time became an elusive companion, slipping through their fingers like the spectral shadows that now constantly danced at the edge of their vision. The whispers grew louder, the visions more frequent, and the spectral force's impending rise became an undeniable reality. Their world was unraveling, reshaping itself around the ancient pact that had lain dormant for centuries. Amidst the growing cacophony of spectral whispers and the looming threat of the spectral force, they stood together, their determination unwavering. They were prepared, they were willing, and they had no other choice but to face the spectral force head on. The capital had never felt more alive, pulsating with a spectral energy that coalesced and swirled, casting long, shifting shadows against the neoclassical architecture. The ethereal whispers hung in the air like the melody of an unfinished symphony, rising and falling in an erratic rhythm. The spectral force was at its zenith, stretching at the thin veil that separated it from the realm of the living. In the heart of this spectral maelstrom, Margaret and Tomas, with their elderly ally by their side, began the ritual to reinforce the oath. The old chants resonated against the stone walls, seeping into the very fabric of the capital, a song of age-old responsibility. Each syllable carried the weight of the promise, the spectral chain that had been forged by Margaret's ancestors. Margaret's world spiraled into a flurry of visions. Her ancestors' faces flashed before her eyes, stern and resilient. She saw the original architects, their hands laying the foundations of the capital, their voices sealing away the spectral force. This journey through her lineage was not a mere retelling of history. It was a confirmation of her destiny, her connection to the oath becoming stronger with each vision. The spectral force raged against the invocation of the oath. A chilling wind swept through the hall, carrying the spectral whispers that swirled around Margaret. It was an intimidating presence, a maelstrom of energy that threatened to consume her. Yet Margaret stood tall, the legacy of her lineage, the strength of her resolve, and the truth of the oath shielding her against the spectral onslaught. Tomas, his eyes never leaving Margaret, continued the ritual. His voice steady, his resolve unwavering, he recited the chants, maintaining the rhythm that held the spectral force at bay. His role was no less important, the beacon of hope that illuminated Margaret's path, the companion that shared the burden of her destiny. The struggle between the spectral force and the oathkeepers seemed to stretch into eternity, an intense dance between the realms of the living and the spectral. Margaret, in her determined stand, pushed back against the spectral force. With the final words of the oath falling from her lips, the spectral force was forced to retreat, once again sealed away by the power of the oath. Margaret felt a sudden release of tension, like the calm after a storm. She collapsed, the strain of the ordeal leaving her weak but victorious. Tomas rushed to her side, his relief evident in his eyes. The capital, once the stage for a spectral showdown, returned to its usual grandeur. The shadows receded, and the whispers fell silent. In the aftermath of their ordeal, Margaret and Tomas found themselves in the quiet comfort of their shared experience. Their relationship had evolved, forged in the spectral fire and strengthened by their mutual resolve. The truth of the oath had reshaped their world, opening them to the reality of the spectral force and their roles as its guardians. Margaret, now firmly rooted in her lineage and her role as an oathkeeper, looked to the future with renewed determination. The spectral force might have retreated, but the oath was a constant, a promise that had to be upheld, a chain that would always bind her to the spectral force. Tomas, standing by her side, echoed her resolve. Their journey through spectral whispers and ancestral truths came to a close, but their vigilance remained. Margaret, the guardian of the oath, and Tomas, her steadfast ally, stood at the dawn of a new chapter in their lives. Their roles had been defined, their responsibilities embraced, and they were ready for the spectral challenges that lay ahead. As our story comes to a close, let the lull of this soothing ambiance continue to cradle you further into your journey of calmness and rest. Thank you for allowing me to be a part of your relaxation and sleep routine tonight. Remember, each day brings a new story, and each night brings a fresh chance to regenerate, to dream, and to become more of who you are. As this background sound lulls you further into sleep, I hope you find peace, comfort, and a well-deserved rest. Good night, dear listener. Until our next story, sleep well and dream beautifully.